The following is a class on the disappearance day of His Divine Grace, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 9th, 1968, in Los Angeles.
So, today is the disappearance day of my Guru Maharaj. As I told you, that sadhava jiva ma marova. There was a nice story the other day I told you, that a sage is giving different kinds of blessings to different types of persons. So to a king's son, a prince, he blessed Rajaputta Chiranjiva. Oh, you are king's son, prince, you live forever. And Muniputra, the son of a saintly person, he blessed him, ma jiva, you don't live. Rajaputra chiranga jiva, muniputra, ma jiva. And sadhu, devotee, he blessed him, jiva va marova, either you live or you die, as you like. And there was a butcher. He blessed him, ma jiva ma maro, you don't die, don't live. So these words are very significant. That I have already explained, still I am explaining. The prince is enjoying sense, that's all. He has got enough facility for sense enjoyment. So his next life is hellish. Because if you indulge in sex life, then Krishna will give you facility to have sex life 3 times in an hour. Just like the pigeons, the monkeys, the sparrows, they are very sexually strong. You have seen it. So the facility is given. So princely order, they are after sense enjoyment. So he is blessed that better you live forever, because after your death you do not know what is going to happen to you. You are going to get a hellish life. Better you live for some time. Go on with your enjoyment. And Muniputra, ma jiva, brahmachari, working under the guidance, under strict disciplinary guidance of his spiritual master, he is blessed, ma jiva. So you better die, because you are so trained to enter into the kingdom of God, so why should you take so much trouble? Better you die and go back to God. Ma jiva. And a devotee, he blessed, jivo va marova, my dear devotee, either you live or die, the same thing. And the butcher, he blessed him, ma jiva ma marova, you don't live, don't die. What is to do? His living condition is so abominable. From the morning he has to slaughter so many animals, see the blood stained, the ghastly scene, that is his livelihood. So what a horrible life this is. So don't live. And don't die also. Because after death, he is going to be in so much hellish condition, nobody can describe. So both life, living condition and death, after death, his condition is very horrible. Anyway, apart from others, the devotee, for him, appearance and disappearance, the same thing. Just like when my spiritual master appeared at Jagannath Puri, he was the son of a very big government office, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He was magistrate, government officer, and in those days a magistrate is a big officer in the government, practically next to governor. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur was in charge of the Jagannath temple. That is the system in Jagannath Puri. The manager in charge of the temple is the district magistrate. So there was Ratha Yatra festival, and the car was passing in front of Bhaktivinoda Thakur's house. Bhaktivinoda Thakur's name was Kedarnath Dutta. When he was magistrate, he was known as Ken Dutta, Kedarnath Dutta. So the car stopped before his house, and at that time, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, a child in the lap of his mother, the mother took the opportunity of rising on the car. He was magistrate's wife, so he had the facility. Immediately people gave her a way to go in on the top of the car and place the child on the lotus feet of Jagannath, and there were many garlands. One garland fell upon him. Bhaktisiddhanta says, blessings. This was one of the there are so many other things. When he was a child, 2-3 years old, he ate one mango fruit which was kept for offering to the deity. So his father mildly rebuked him, "Oh, you have done very wrong thing. It was meant for deity and you have taken it. You should not have done it." The child was 2 or 3 years old. He took it so seriously that never after that he took mango. Whenever we offered him mango, he said, "No, I am offended. I cannot take mango." He was thinking like that. You see, never in his life he took a mango. He was thinking that I offended in my childhood by taking the mango of the deity. Well, this is the characteristic of acharya. They teach by their life action that one should be so much determined that one should not be a child took the mango, there is no offense. But he took that vow. Another instance, in my presence, at that time we are also young men, and one of my god brothers, his name is Dr. Audh Bihari Kapoor. He is now retired in Vrindavan. Last time I saw him, he was also a young man, and his wife was also young. So we were sitting together talking with Guru Maharaj, and the girl proposed, "My dear master, I want to speak with you." So Guru Maharaj said, "Yes, you can talk whatever you like." So she said, "I want to talk with you secretly." not in the presence of everyone. The Guru Maharaj said, no, I cannot talk with you secretly. You can talk in the presence of my all other disciples. So, even that girl was just like his granddaughter by age calculation. He refused to talk with a young woman in a secret place. These are the instances. So, in his life, he was Akhanda Brahmachari. Bhaktivinoda Thakur had many other sons, and he was the fifth son. And some of his other brother also, they did not marry. And my Guru Maharaj, he also did not marry. From the childhood, he is strict brahmachari. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj. And he underwent very severe penances for starting this movement, worldwide movement. That was his mission. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to do this. He, 1896, Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to introduce this Krishna consciousness movement by sending his this book, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, His Life and Precepts. Fortunately, that year was my birth year, and by Krishna's arrangement, we came in contact. I was born in a different family. My Guru Maharaj was born in a different family. Who knew that I will come to his protection? Who knew that I would come in America? Who knew that you American boys will come to me? These are all Krishna's arrangement. We cannot understand how things are taking place. In 1936, today is 9th December, 1938. That means 32 years ago. In Bombay, I was then doing some business. All of a sudden, but perhaps on this date, sometimes between 9 or 10 December, at that time, Guru Maharaj was indisposed little, and he was staying at Jagannath Puri on the seashore. So I wrote him later, my dear master, your other disciples, brahmachari, sannyasi, they are rendering you direct service, and I am a householder. I cannot live with you. I cannot serve you nicely. So I do not know how can I serve. Simply an idea, I was thinking of serving him. How can I serve him seriously? So the reply was dated 13th December 1936. In that letter, he wrote, my dear such and such, I am very glad to receive your letter. I think you should try to push our movement in English. That was his writing. And that will be good to you and to the people who will help you. And that was his instruction. And then in 1936, on the 31st December, That means just after writing this letter, a fortnight before his departure, he passed away. But I took that order of my spiritual master very seriously. But I did not think that I'll have to do such and such thing. I was at that time a householder. But this is the arrangement of Krishna. If we strictly try to serve the spiritual master, his order, then Krishna will give us all facilities. That is the secret. Although there was no possibility, I never thought, but I took it little seriously by studying a commentary by Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur on the Bhagavad Gita. In the Bhagavad Gita, the verse Bhavasadmika Buddhi Rekiha Kurunandana, in connection with that verse, Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur gives his commentary that we should take up the words from the spiritual master as our life and soul. We should try to carry out the instruction, the specific instruction of the spiritual master very rigidly, without caring for our personal benefit or loss. So, I tried a little bit in that spirit. So he has given me all facilities to serve him. Things have come to this stage that in this old age I have come to your country and you are also taking this movement seriously, trying to understand if we have got some books now. So there is little foothold of this movement. Now on this occasion of my spiritual master's departure, as I am trying to execute his will, similarly I shall also request you to execute the same order through my will. I am an old man. I can also pass away at any moment. That is nature's law. Nobody can check it. So that is not very astonishing. But my appeal to you on this auspicious day of the departure of my Guru Maharaj, that at least to some extent you have understood the essence of Krishna consciousness movement, you should try to push it on. People are suffering for want of this consciousness. As we daily pray about devotees, vanchakalpatarubhascha kripasindubhayavacha patitanam pavanibhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namo. A Vaishnava, a devotee of Lord, his life is dedicated for the benefit of the people. You know, most of you belong to Christian community, how Lord Jesus Christ, he says that for your sinful activities, he has sacrificed himself. That is the determination of devotee of the Lord. They don't care for personal comforts because they love Krishna or God. Therefore they love all living entities because all living entities are in relationship with Krishna. So, similarly, you should learn. This Krishna consciousness Movement means to become Vaishnava and feel for the suffering humanity. So to feel for the suffering humanity, there are different angles of vision. Somebody is thinking of the suffering of the humanity from bodily conception of life. Somebody is trying to open hospital to give a relief to the diseased condition. Somebody is trying to distribute foodstuff in poverty-stricken countries or places. These things are certainly very nice. But actual suffering of the humanity is due to Krishna, lack of Krishna consciousness. These bodily sufferings, they are temporary, neither they can be checked by the laws of nature. Suppose if you give some distribution of foodstuff in some poverty-stricken country, that does not mean that this help makes solution of the whole problem. The real beneficial work is to invoke every person to Krishna consciousness. As soon as he comes to Krishna consciousness, the same example as I have given several times, that a rich man's son is loitering in the street, forgetting his father's opulence and property. And somebody out of sympathy giving him some food. But other person comes to him and says, "Oh, my dear boy, I know you. You are the son of such and such rich man. Why you are loitering in the street? Come on, I shall take you to your father." So that gentleman takes that loitering boy to his father. The father is glad, and the boy inherits his father's property, and his whole problem of life becomes solved. This is a crude example. Similarly, all living entities, they are loitering within this universe in different bodies, in different planets, and from time immemorial, without knowing that he belongs to the kingdom of God. He is the direct son of Krishna and God. If Krishna is the proprietor of everything, and he can enjoy his father's property, and these problems of material condition life automatically solved. Just like if you become a rich man, if you can possess millions of dollars, then your poverty is automatically solved. Similarly, if you become Krishna conscious, and if you act in that way, then all other problems in the material condition of life solved. So this is such a nice moment. Ahantang sarvapapibha mukhvishyami maasuchi. The Bhagavad Gita says, the Lord says, people's sufferings are due to his sinful activities. Ignorance is the cause of sinful activity. Just like a man does not know. Suppose a foreigner like me comes in America and he does not know, because in India, just like in your country, the car is driven from the right side. In India, I have seen in London also, the car is driven from the left side. So suppose he does not know, he drives the car on the left side and incurs some accident, and he is taken by the police custody, and if he says, "Sir, I did not know that here the car is driven from the right side," That does not make him excused. The law will punish him. So ignorance is the cause of breaking the law or sinful activity. And as soon as you commit some sinful activity, you have to suffer the result. So the whole world is in ignorance, and due to ignorance is complicated in so many actions and reactions, either good or bad. There is nothing good within this material world, everything is bad. So we have manufactured something good and something bad. Here, because in the Bhagavad Gita we understand, this place is dukkhalayam asasata. This place is for misery. So how you can say, in miserable condition, how you can say that this is good or this is bad? Everything is bad. So those persons who do not know the material condition and die, they manufacture something, this is good, this is bad, because they do not know everything here is bad, nothing good. One should be very pessimistic of this material world, then he can make advance in spiritual life. Dukkhalam asas. This place is full of miseries, and if you study analytically, you will find simply miserable condition. Therefore, the whole problem is that we should give up our material condition and life, and in Krishna consciousness, we should try to elevate ourselves to the spiritual platform and thereby be promoted to the kingdom of Godhead. Jadgatyana nivartante tadhyamam paramam mama. We are going, nobody comes back to this miserable world, and that is the supreme abode of the Lord. So there are descriptions in the Bhagavad Gita. So this Krishna consciousness movement is authorized, very important. Now, you American boys and girls who have taken to this movement, please take it more seriously, and that is the mission of Lord Chaitanya and my Guru Maharaj, and we are also trying to execute the will by disciplic succession. You have come forward to help me. I shall request you all that I shall go away, but you shall leave. Don't give up pushing on this movement, and you will be blessed by Lord Chaitanya and His divine grace, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada. Thank you very much.